Coach Adams, Bryson Williams, and Adonis Arms here. We'll start with an opening statement from Coach. Coach, whenever you're ready.
Yes, ma'am. Well, first of all, we want to really congratulate Duke on a great game, great second half, a very, very good team, and obviously very well coached. So, you know, this is a tough time for us. Your season ends. I think there's a Bible verse that says you mourn with those who mourn and celebrate those who celebrate. And we're going to have a lot of time to celebrate. This has been an unbelievable year, but I've got a lot of guys tearing up in that locker room. And so this is a time that we'll mourn a little bit. But love these guys. So blessed that I had the opportunity to coach them. And I wish I could coach for another game. But I just can't express, you know, how much I appreciate the work habits and how coachable these guys are, how much they love each other, the family atmosphere that we had. And it was just so enjoyable for me. And this will be a team that I'll always remember. And they had a great year. We broke a lot of records. And he's responsible. Some of these guys who are up here with me are largely responsible for that. But anyway, we'll get through tonight.
Questions? Start up here in the front.
Joseph Hoyt, Dallas Morning News. Bryson, they made all of their last eight field goals. I guess just how hard was it to stop that kind of train defensively when it was going like that?
I mean, when you play in a team like Duke, that's, has such so much firepower on the offensive end, and a lot of guys that can do a lot of great things on the floor one-on-one, I mean, it's always going to be hard to stop. Those guys had momentum going into the end of the game, and they took fully advantage of it. So, just hats off to them. I mean, they played great on the offensive end towards the end of the game.
Question to the left.
This is for Coach Mark Canizaro from the New York Post. I'm curious what your impressions of what you saw from Banchero tonight and how much he hurt you guys in some of those spurts.
Well, I mean, he's a great player. And, you know, our scouting report, our preparation was all about not giving him as many touches. He's not a great three-point shooter on paper, but he proved that he can really shoot it tonight and made a lot of big plays for him. So we were trying to not let him catch the ball, talked about there in timeouts. But, great players find a way to get the ball and make the big plays, and he certainly did that.
Next question to the right.
Carlos Silva from the Lubbock Avalanche Journal. Adonis, obviously you guys were able to make it close later on. Can you just speak to the fight this team has had throughout the year and what the message is or just kind of what the story is of this team? I know it's right after, but I guess what can you kind of put into words is what the story is of this team that got put together so quickly and made a special run?
I mean, in my opinion, we got the best coach in college basketball to my right. So when we follow his lead and list everything he has to say when it comes to, you know, fighting and never wanting to lose, like hating to lose and stuff like that. And then you get a full team like myself and Bryson, that's a bunch of veterans coming in to actually buy into that and believe in each other and love each other and, you know, just want to win every single possession, every single game and hate losing. I mean, all credit goes to Coach Adams. I mean, his mindset, his, like, every day of, you know, watching film, breaking it down to the smallest thing, and we actually buy into it. There's no clicks or anything like that. There's none of that on this team. So I just think it hat goes off to Coach Adams, you know, for him to lay down the table and for us to, you know, buy into it and love him as a coach and a person at the same time. In my opinion, it's the greatest team I've ever been on. So, I mean, I love these guys. I'll never forget them, especially Coach Adams. He's probably my favorite coach I've ever played for. So that's how I feel about it.
Question on the left.
Mason Hordisky from KMAC News. For both of you guys, kind of to bounce off of that, with how quickly this team was assembled and how you guys came from all different walks of life, what made it so easy for you guys to kind of latch onto each other and the rest of your teammates in Red Raider culture?
I mean, you just reiterated what Donna said. Coach Adams, I mean, he's the greatest coach in the country. For him to be able to pull a group of guys together who were all the men at the previous institutions, and just get us to buy in and believe in team and make us love playing defense. That's special. And then also, I would like to say the Texas Tech. I mean, this is the institution, the love and the support and just the way the fans and everybody was just behind us, and everybody that's involved with Texas Tech, and it's just amazing. I mean, it was a blessing to be here. It was a blessing for all of us to play here. I'll remember these guys for the rest of my life. I'll remember Coach Adams for the rest of my life, and everybody on that coaching staff, every manager, every GA, even the janitors that work at Texas Tech, I'll remember them. So, I mean, it was just a blessing to be here. And, we fought hard, and that's all we're going to do always is fight hard.
Question in the middle.
Hey, guys. Brady King, Fox 34 in Lubbock. Coach, hearing that from your players, you're clearly very, very loved. How does it feel to hear that? And can you just sum up how special your first year as a head coach at Texas Tech has been?
Yeah, well, y'all get a small taste of what I get to enjoy every day with these guys. They're been doing this a long time, and this is a team that really loves the game and plays a lot of motion. And they love each other, and they laugh a lot, and that same emotion, they're so competitive when they need to be, and it was just a joy to coach, and our coaching staff is so thankful, and I'm just so blessed that God's put me in a situation and put these guys in my life, and I don't think I'm deserving to have these guys, but I'm so thankful that I was able to coach these guys and the rest of them and on this team, just very special. And yeah, I'm just so sad that we have to, see this season come to an end, because we want to keep, we want to keep playing. So, we just love competing together, and we love being in the same foxhole and going out and fighting together.
Question on the left.
Yeah, this is for Adonis. Mike DeCourcy from Sporting News. When they switched to zone, were you surprised by it? It seemed like you guys hit it really hard early, and then they adjusted a little bit. Could you sense the adjustment, and is that what caused you guys the problems a couple of possessions that changed the game there?
They have a Hall of Fame coach, and Coach K over there, so he was trying to find a way to slow us down, because we were scoring, giving the ball to Bryson, and just attacking their gaps or their zone. But I think that the hat goes off to Kevin McCullough for that call, noticing that they were switching from man to zone quickly, and then me recognizing it and getting us in our sets. I just think if we would just recognize it a little quicker, we'll have been fine. But it was a great adjustment from Coach K. I have all faith in my team and my guys to figure out what play we need to run and stuff like that. But that was basically it.
Question in the back left. Question up front here.
Mason Ordisky with KMAC. Coach, just kind of looking back at the beginning of the year and where the team was in last spring and where they obviously end the season now, can you just reiterate, I guess, how proud you are of how they were able to fight through adversity and even make it back to this position when a lot of people maybe have counted out the Red Raiders early on?
Sure. You start looking at some of the critics and the polls, we weren't we weren't expected to do very well. But I think, simply put, we just had a team that exceeded all expectations. And the credit goes to these guys and our coaching staff for putting together the right guys that would fit here and that wanted to play defense and wanted to, play for each other and sacrifice a lot of individual maybe goals for the betterment of the team. I thought it was this – it's an unbelievable year. It's just a team that was just reached all kinds of heights no one ever thought was possible.
We'll go to the right for the final question.
Carlos Silva from the Lubbock Avalanche Journal. Adonis, Bryson, this is for both of you. What do you feel y'all have left as a legacy for this team? Because I know certainly they've been on the uptick getting to the Elite Eight National Championship game, but you guys have obviously made your own path here. What do you feel each of you, if you can just answer personally for yourself, that you've left as either this team or just as an individual?
I would say that we left that the culture works, that if you believe in what Coach Adams says every single day and you take it to heart and you fight every single game, you're going to be in every single game. I think the legacy that I left for myself is, it's what I started with when I started to play basketball, was never quit, never give up, and believe in God first. So that's always going to be my legacy. That's what I left here at Texas Tech. And again, I just want to credit Coach Adams for giving me the opportunity to do that.
I would say this team left the legacy of, you know, hard work and just coming in every game and knowing that you could lose to anybody, you know, and preparation is key. I feel like this team, we prepare for everybody that we play against just to a T. We spend multiple hours in the hotel rooms and at the gyms, in our practice facility. I mean, just preparing for people that we play. So how important preparation is and just being ready to fight. And then I would say individually, I mean, the legacy I was trying to leave here is there's anything you want to do, you got to work for it and you got to go get it. And that's what I love so much about Coach Adams. He's the same way. I mean, he wants something, he's going to go get it or he's going to go take it. And I feel like that's what I love, because I want to leave it all on the floor, go take it, and having a strong faith in God, of course.
Thanks, guys.
Appreciate it. Thank you. God bless you.